Just want to say, happy to be back here. It's been a long time coming. You know, we started as a young boy, you know, with Coach Danny Orton, was nurtured me to this stage in my life and helped me to be the person that I am today. To see all the kids running remind me of my days. Not the cool part of it, but but just the camaraderie and I running and against all the schools, you know, for bragging rights and, you know, for what Team Bickle has been doing for the Jamaica, as well, and also from the Penn Relays to recognize what our prowess and what the team has done. It's been good of them, and I'm really happy.
Awesome. All right, we'll open it up for some questions. When I point to you, just say your name and who you're affiliated with.
Okay. Jonathan Tannenbaum of the Philadelphia Inquirer here in town. I think a lot of us remember when you ran with Usain Bolt here, and there were 54,000 people here, and it was so electric. What are your memories of that, first of all?
My memories was the first time as a senior running and the team, and also on the Jamaican team when they put it together. And you know, when we came out, it was a bit cold, yes, because, you know, we're training to a hot climate in Jamaica. And I hear the crowd going off, and I see everywhere, every stand have people, and I say, yo, to myself, and I say, yeah, this is the moment, you know, you have been working for, this is it. And you see him come to me and say, yo, you want to get to? You got to run fast, and I say, of course, man. You know, because, you know, I get nervous at times, and he always encouraging me, and from then on, when I got the button, I just flew down the box straight away, and I could see us in front.
And it's been a couple of years now since the last USA versus the World exhibition. There was the pandemic. There's been some changes, obviously, in the track world and stuff like that. Do you hope to see something big like that get back here, maybe in the future?
I've asked about it, and I know there's been a lot of changes, and I've seen the changes. Changes are good, but one of the changes they can rule out is the Jamaica versus the US is always one of the biggest thing people come here for, not just the high school only, but to see the US and Jamaica at it, you know, because we have been at it over the years, and definitely, I would love for it to come back again.
Impact national masters news. We're in here as a high schooler, and we have fellow countrymen and countrywomen high schoolers here today. How do you feel about the state of Jamaican track and field? Is it in good hands for the future?
And everything we're doing, there are going to be changes, you know, and you know, you're going to have some down moments, and then you're going to have some up moments, and I believe that, you know, we're apart from the females, the male are taking their time transitioning. We have some really good athletes coming up as well, you know. And also, if you watch the high schoolers, we have some really good talent out there. It's just how we harness the talent after that, and how much we don't try to raise the kids into a state where they can't perform when they reach the senior level. If one thing, you know, throughout St. Jago history, you know, one thing they make sure of that. We sustain, and if you look and Coach Dan record, we don't run ourselves to wreck. We still can stand tall after we leave high school. There's so much kids that leave high school and can't further on. So I'm really happy to see the young one coming up.
Anderson Emerald here. During your time at Penn Relays, the first time you did come, you know, when you were in high school, did you imagine, did that kind of spark the thought process of having the illustrious career that you ended up having?
I always thought that, you know, when I was at St. Jago, you know, a coach always said to me, you know, you're going to be big out there, you know, and I'm always say, yeah, you know, but I didn't know that it would be that big, and running at Penn Relays, you know, as a youngster, you know, Coach Danny Truman, the team, and say, you got this, man. And of course, you know, I go out there and I represent well. You know, it was a bit nerve-wracking to see so much people in the stands and running in front of a crowd, and, you know, coming out of a, you know, Montego Bay, coming into Kingston, and coming to a place where it's really cold, my first time overseas. You know, normally I can really don't have nowhere to warm up. You know, so coach is all of a sudden I feel right there, probably getting some tiger balm inside there and cold, you know. But in the end, it's all worth it, and if I should do it again, I would. Life evolves, things and time changes. I would say I'm a person from 10,000 BC. They don't make people like me anymore. But because during my time there wasn't a lot of gadgets. You know, we could go outside and we could run up and down, and we could have fun, and I'm not at home, just stuck on my iPad, you know. And but what we say to them is that being very intelligent, not to procrastinate too much, and I would say just enjoy every moment of it, and knowing that something can come of this. When I look at my family, you know, and where I'm coming from, and to use that to fuel me, you know, to be the better version of myself, not just only on the track but off the track as well, and to where I see myself, and to treat people how they should be treated, and don't take things for granted. When I was much younger, I worked very, very, very hard, vomiting every day, you know. And sometime in training I do blackout, you know, to be the person that I am today, you know. So I would tell them that believe in yourself, because one day you could be at this stage. Because look at me, if I look back 2007, I know I would be talking to a room full of person, you know, and having given what I've got today from the Penn Relays to be in the Hall of Fame for the rest of my life.
Harry John, out of New York. You exist in an environment in the world where phenom, Usain Bolt. Your accomplishments would be the marquee for any other nation. To exist beneath that, with that, those kind of things, will it motivate you? Will it deter you? How did you conceptualize and operate in that sphere? You're the second fastest man in the history of the world, but you exist in Jamaica with the fastest man in the history.
To be honest, Mr. Clare, I'm grateful. I'm a man of the Bible, and there was a lot of great kings during King David time, and David didn't get to live his true kingliness in the Bible. And I wouldn't change anything, because I've come into a time where they have great kings, and I would say Usain Bolt was a great king, and I've come up against him. And if there wasn't certain things, I could have taken down that king. But I give him all the respect he deserves, because I've been training with him for the last 10 years, and trust me, he's not a normal man, you know. And for me to beat him, I have to be working over. When he's sleeping, I'm at the gym, and I say, oh, this is where I can beat him. I have to overwork for me to get in front that day when I beat him twice. You know, and after that, you say, you want this now, but I'm like, no, make sure it work, if I'm sleeping in the day. So, you know, I'm grateful. I give God thanks for everything that I've done. I'm not going to complain. I'm grateful because I made a life of it, and I am the person that I am today, you know, whether in the shadow or out of the shadow, It's just something you just can't control, and you're born into a time where it was just tough out here in the track and field world. There's a many underneath me that even don't even get a light for themselves, you know, that was really good at that time as well. So I'm grateful.
So, Mr. Blake, a couple years ago, I'm Director William of the Coalition for Jamaica. And I have a question. Back in the days, you used to do a lot of donation spikes and bags and stuff. Are you still currently doing that?
Well, I'm doing it to my foundation. I have 30 kids. I just built a facility in Mandeville to take in a lot of kids as well. You know, there's a lot of kids that are found in caves that have been raped. You know, there are wards of the state. So that my job is to take them away from what the government is not doing to be, and I am doing it, you know, because I think they're the future, and we're getting old, and everybody's stepping down, and they're one going to step up. So we have to, I have to look in the mirror every day and say, we're going to make that change, that person in the mirror. So I have to, and most of my earnings go towards my foundation, you know, because that I am a shepherd, I am a flock of God, so that's my job.
Any questions?
Just, you know, you were mentioning family, you were mentioning, you know, the coach and, you know, all the people who were around you. Can you talk a little bit about the support system and the people who kind of guided you through your career over the, you know, decade plus?
You know, back then, you know, Mr. Uncle talked to Danny out and said, Danny, I have a young kid for you, you know. You know, I wasn't that good. But one thing that Coach Danny did is just to develop me, not just only physically, but he trained me mentally, because he knew what the world have to offer. Most of his teaching come through gesticulating of knowledge. He don't only coaches us, he teaches us, you know. And he also, you know, he and his wife brought me to their home to live, to just to control what I do, and just to make sure they have a good prospect came out of Jamaica. And you know, up to today they I'm grateful for that, because if it wasn't for that, you know, getting up every morning, running the hills at GC, running on the road, running around, you know, and getting strong, because we're the team at San Diego. We used to run 4x1, 4x4. We have the heats, we have the finals, you know, we have to do almost, you know, everything you want us to run, you know, even the 600 at training. And he really nurtures us. And to be honest, I'm grateful, you know, and I can stand tall that, you know, he's the one that paved my way to the person that I am today, not just on the track, but off the track as a person.
So, could you repeat the name of the foundation for one and second? Are you preparing for the next Olympics?
Yeah, my foundation is the Why Be Afraid Foundation. Why I said the Why Be Afraid is because of my name, Yohan Blake, and the Afraid is, and the A is my last name, Andre. So why be afraid to give? Why be afraid to help? You know, so it came from that line. I'm preparing for the World Championship this year in Budapest. And definitely, I think my last should be, based on my agent, I think she don't want me to stop. But I think the Olympics are looking for to be my last run, because I love the movies and also I love cricket. I want to play the Indian Premier League, and I want to do the movies as well. So I have choices, you know. Thank God for that. So that's where I'm heading.
Any other questions left?
Yeah.
I must commend you for what you just said. Don't forget me to come.
You cannot.
This man is talking. I don't have to hear.
Thank you very much, man. We appreciate it.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, your newest addition to the Penn Relays Wall of Fame, Yohan Blake.